care and evaluation is extremely important, but it's also important to understand the differences between a mammogram, ultrasound, and MRI, and when each is needed.
Here to break it all down for us is Dr. V from the Northwestern Specialists for Women. Thanks for being here.
It's my pleasure.
Okay, so I've always had to get the combo, like ultrasound, something else, and I don't even understand what it is, but I know I have to get it specially from my doctor to go.
Sure. So the first thing I'm going to remind everybody, I'm putting the shout out here, is go back and see your doctors. Over 50% of women stopped getting their health care during the pandemic in 2020, and most of them have not returned back to getting health care, including breast exams and talking to their doctor about what is their history, has the family history changed, what kind of imaging do you need, is it a mammogram, is it an ultrasound, is it an MRI? So go back and see your doctor and let's get that taken care of. In answer to your question, the average woman who has no increased risks for breast cancer, no family history, genetic diseases, first screening exam should be at age 40, 1 to 2 years, talk to your doctor, and then based on the mammogram, you may hear something about dense breasts, and that's what starts dictating what you need or don't need.
Okay, so is it that they see something there or they can't see something, and that's what precipitates an MRI or an or
it's a little bit of both. So dense breasts, the definition is actually a mammogram-based definition, meaning that the tissue is graded from a sense of being really fatty over to being a little bit more fibrous. But the problem is that mammogram will read dense tissue, which in and of itself is normal tissue, but it highlights the same way as a tumor might. And therefore, dense breasts may mask a tumor that might be existing there. And that's where ultrasound and MRI may be the better modality to be able to see that dense. One thing I want to put out there, though, also is especially if you're first starting to get mammograms, you may get called back. 10 to 25% of women will get called back for an additional view. That's different than an ultrasound or an MRI.
Okay.
Your mammogram is learning about your breast.
Yes.
They need to see a few images over the course of a couple of years, and sometimes you may need an additional view of your breast to be able to see the composite picture.
Well, and what the first one I went to, it was just a mammogram, and then it got back, came back dense, and then they wanted to do a biopsy, and that, and it was all fine, but all of that along the way is scary. Do you ever worry that people are going to get scared away from the tests?
Absolutely, which is one of the reasons why there's so much controversy, even amongst all the great, you know, research organizations that we have, of when should mammograms start? When should we get an ultrasound? When should we get an MRI? Because we are worried about these false positives, that maybe we're overreading things and then, you know, ending up having a woman be anxious and needing a biopsy that maybe she doesn't need. Okay. So again, coming back to your OBGYN, coming back to your doctor, going through that family history, getting your exam done can sometimes help parse out what really is needed or not.
Okay, so mammograms hurt. All right, I'm just gonna put it out there. I mean, squishing it like a pancake.
It hurts.
20 seconds.
And 20 seconds
per breast. We can all put up with 20 seconds per breast.
But your baby hurts. This doesn't.
Well, I had great drugs. So. no, but what I'm getting at is, because it is uncomfortable, and in my case, it hurts, why can't you just do an ultrasound or an MRI and skip the mammogram?
Because interesting is mammogram is still the gold standard for detecting breast cancer, and it is the only modality that has actually been shown to decrease the risk of mortality or death.
Okay.
So ultrasound and MRI can be used as supplements. And for example, if you are a genetic carrier, let's say you have BRCA1 or BRCA2, then we know an MRI may be the better modality. Sometimes when you're a little younger, 40 or 41, with the denser breasts, remember, we have living tissue when we're premenopausal. So our breasts are going to tend to be a little bit denser than it will be when we're postmenopausal. Mammograms were meant for postmenopausal women, right?
Ooh.
Now we've introduced it earlier at age 40 when we're premenopausal. So some of those things also need to be sorted out.
Okay,
that makes much more sense. But you saying 1 to 2 years, it's not every year per se, or is it just a conversation you have with your doctor?
It's a conversation you have. For the average woman who does not have any elevated risk for breast cancer, it can be a discussion with your doctor. Get your first screening mammogram at age 40. That should definitely be there. And then some women are a little bit more like, I might not want that little bit of radiation that a mammogram, you know, may confer. fine, let's make it an 18-month schedule, mm-hmm. you know?
Okay.
I think the most important thing is seeing your doctor yearly, getting your mammograms in a timely fashion that both you and your doctor have decided upon.
All right, and then circling back on something you said, that because so many women have not gone and taken care of their health care, I went to schedule mine, and I can't get in until February.
So for a mammogram, you're talking about.
For a mammogram,
because
yeah.
I'll say for your appointments, you should be able to get in
sure.
much sooner
yes.
with your OBGYN. We're
mammogram.
Making time to make sure our women can get back in.
Yes.
And that's just because of the backlog. And this is a national trend. This is not
okay.
just in Chicago.
Okay.
Because there was a 99% reduction in mammogram in 2020. I mean, okay. nobody was coming out and getting
yeah.
them. All of a sudden, women are realizing we've got to take care of our health, right?
Yeah.
And so they're getting scheduled. There are ways. Talk to your doctor. Sometimes if you have a higher risk, we can get you in sooner. We can get you in different locations. We'll make sure that you're getting the right screening that you need in a timely fashion.
All right. Dr. V, thank you so much. As always, information there for Northwestern Specialists for Women. They're over on Kingsbury. There's a phone number, social media handles, as well as the website. Always great talking to you, Dr. V.
My pleasure.